You know what? I think it's time for more stalker stories. So how about the time I went through Red Forest for the first time? Because Red Forest is such a fun fucking place. So, you know me, professional stalker, right? So, I already knew the hellhole that Red Forest was, unlike some. So, my first encounter went way smoother than most others. So I went through and was searching the place, right? Was looking. I came to Red Forest because it was the fastest way to a target I was supposed to be bounty hunting, right? And trust me, that bounty hunting target is a whole nother story. So I was in the swamp place, swamp safe house, right? I pick up a contract saying, oh, hey, there's a guy down. I was doing bounty contracts at the time, so I was, after doing a few, I was told, hey, there's this guy. He owes a lot of people a lot of money, so they put a contract on his head. He's worth like 8,000 rubles, right? So I'm like, all right, I'll go with this. So I grab my AK, I grab my shotgun. I'm on my merry way, right? Yes, I look at the giant weird fire anomaly that's like along the way there. So that's pretty cool. Kept walking. I had to go through the wild territories. So before that is a duty outpost, and before that is like some other place. So I went through that place, right? Found it to not be that fun, so I decided to take the short route, go through Red Forest, right? Because the other route was like another three areas, and I didn't feel like doing that. And if I went through Red Forest, it was only another two. So I go to Red Forest, knowing full well I'm probably gonna get my ass chewed out. The outside of the Red Forest Park area was perfectly calm. I saw this like 3-4 story concrete building with like a metal structure next to it. I'm not sure exactly what it was. But I go up to it, right? I go climb up the thing, and I see there's a guy up there. I talk to him, and he warns me about how Red Forest practically protects itself with all the anomalies and mutants, and generally how hostile it is, right? So I'm like, alright, this is a pretty fucking dangerous place, I guess. So train of thought fucking melted there. So what happens is I go to fuck. I hate when my brain shuts down. It's like I'm in the middle of something cool and then it shuts down. Okay, no. So what happens is I go into the Red Forest, right? Red Forest being the fun place it is. And I immediately hear gunfire, right? And I'm like, okay, good start. Great start. Lots of gunfire, right? Turns out it's monolith and bandits, right? And it wasn't two small-ass squads either. We're not talking like 3 or 4 fucking monolith versus like 4 or 5 bandits. We're talking like 16, 17 monolith with like exosuits fighting like heavily armed bandits in the middle of fuck all nowhere. Just like, okay, sure, right? And, coincidentally, there was another team, I think, of loners there. Like, this was, like, an actual small squad of, like, 5 or 6. The loners end up engaging both the bandits and Monolith, who already severely wounded one another. So it was basically just mop-up work from there, right, when I got there. So I assist the loners. I tag team Monolith and what's left of Monolith and bandits with them, and I go loot corpses. I grab everything I could as any sensible man, and I was pretty happy because I had like 15, 16 med kits, right? And just regular med kits, not counting like all the extra special ones I have, like the 20-something military med kits and what have you. So I was pretty much like stacked at this point, and I was pretty happy with myself. So I continue following the path that's in Red Forest and came across some anomalies, walked around them, fuck going through those. And then a bloodsucker ambushes me while I'm just like walking through trying to find shit. Gives me a mild heart attack while I'm exploring here. So I loop around the fucking anomaly, trying to bait it into the anomaly while shooting at it. It eventually, being the dumb bloodsucker it is, runs into a fucking gravity anomaly, and this causes it to just fly up in the air, spin in a few circles, and pfft, fucking explodes everywhere. Fucking amazing. Oh, is this out of fuel again? Fuck. Well, good thing I'm making more carbon. Anyway, so what is it? So Bloodsucker dies. I continue on my merry way following the path because I had no clue how to get out of fucking Red Forest. Because if Red Forest, when you look at the PDA map and the mini map, it's literally just fucking trees, just nonstop fucking trees, right? So I end up getting stuck. I end up falling for a loop trap, you know, like where the pathways are a few different loops. I end up like walking circles for like a solid 10-20 minutes before I realize, wait, fuck, I'm just walking circles here. Let's go grab that other research thing. So I go figure out that I'm going circles. Finally get up to the gate, right? The gate was inherently guarded by fucking another bandit squad. And again, this was a large bandit squad of like 9 to 10, somewhere like 9 to 11 bandits, we'll say. I don't remember exactly. But it was a decent sized squad, right? But they didn't have anything terribly crazy. Like nothing that would like, oh shit, I need to go. Like there was no rocket launcher bandits. Essentially. You know. Yeah, no. Sniper bandits, rocket launcher bandits, or bandits with LMGs are just not fun. But, what is it? So, I go and, get out of the area, loop around, to what is it? Oh, yeah. I managed to escape Red Forest. The second area was Scientist HQ, so I just simply slipped through there. And ran on, right? Get to the third area, and I finally go to my target, right? You know where my target's held up? A military fucking compound. Military in Stalker, it's not fun. Not fun at all. And military was already under siege by a bunch, and I do mean a bunch of loners, right? I'm pretty sure like 3 or 4 loner squads were there. There was that many, right? And I think military outnumbered them at least 2-1. On top of that, as soon as I started engaging, you know what happened? Guess what was down the fucking road that decided to drive over? A fucking BTR. So this fuck you anti-infantry vehicle shows up, starts unloading its 20 mil in my general direction. Or sorry, 30 mil. And I'm just like, well, fuck, I'm gonna retreat to the other side where all the loners are, right? Big fucking mistake. They had 2 machine gun nests pinning these guys down and a sniper team just picking them off as they tried to run. I managed to kill the snipers and the machine gunners, but then fucking a squad of riflemen just charge out the fucking complex, gunning everyone they can see, right? A few unlucky rounds managed to hit me through a bush, but I managed to get behind a rock to use plenty of my first aids. And mind you, since the start of this fight, I already burned through at least 6. So having that much just going on all at once was not fun. And then I finally figure out that there's like this super secret fucking route, right? Just like behind the, like on the far top of the hill of the base, right? So I run up all the way there, go inside, and you know what? It does not get any easier. It only got harder. You know what was in there? Military exosuits. As far as the eye could fucking see. And you know what? Fuck military. I ran through hallway after hallway after bunker after bunker, fighting my way just to get into military compound. I ended up bailing on the contract after that. Because you know what? The motherfucker got away. You know what? Fuck it. It ain't worth the trouble.